congregation had several of our children that were part of the school community of Chief Schechter Jewish Day School in Hyde Park. At that time, the school only went up to the sixth grade. But we only had like 64, 65 students in the entire school. And of that 64, 65 students in the school, I believe something between 12 and 14 of those students were members of our congregation, our young children. Amongst that particular crowd was Matthew. I don't know where he went again. You scared his brother. Trey, Aaron, Janelle, Simona, Andy Parker, Michael Bridges boys, Mikael, Avi, Bridge, colored girls were part of the community. And who was the Ralph and that girl's last name? Edwards family, they have three girls that were at the school, and a few other families had their children in. I don't have to tell you that our children literally ran the school. I mean, seriously, they literally ran the school. So much so until they saw our numbers was on the board, they said, well, you need to be either the chair of the board or to lead our school or the vice chair or something. And as a matter of fact, the principal had just left there about 3 months ago. Was a young woman that I had committees to hire many years ago. During the time that our children were studying there, they showed a great capacity to learn. One of the things that I thought would happen is that they would never lose that sense of connectedness to God. It's all right to maybe lose the sense of connectedness to a place, but when you lose that sense of connectedness to God, you have no place to guide your children to. So therefore, the children are left to their own devices. Look at the statistics in this city. Look at the statistics around this country. Look at the conditions that are affecting our people around this world. So it doesn't matter to me if your faith community is whatever it might be, as long as there is a faith community.
Amen.
Because too many of our people are walking around now faithless, thinking that it's all in them and nothing is in you. Because when the eternal touches your behind, you don't ever have to move again. As my brother-in-law, Willie Miller. Strong, young, vibrant. He got out of his car one day, headed into his house. He fell and he's never walked again. I don't think he was planning to fall. I don't think he was planning for that disease to overtake him and bear down him so he couldn't move his legs and walk again. But it happened. And I'll tell you, when you get to places and you have no faith, because you have nothing to have faith in, because all it was all that you thought of yourself, I can only tell you that you are a lost soul. You are a lost soul. Our young sister that is going to be coming today recently celebrated her 40th. So she's a few years removed from being 12 and coming up to be a bat mitzvah. But she said, well, Uncle, I really want to do this and I want to have my bat mitzvah. And I thought it was a good time. And I'm so honored that she chose my birthday to have her bat mitzvah. And so, you know, that was good. And, you know, I said, well, I had no problem giving that up and sharing, because The motto of this congregation is the door of the door, keeping the faith, the door of the door, from generation to generation. So would you please stand and receive the congregation's business manager, our Hebrew teacher, our bar and bat mitzvah trainer. What else are you doing?
Treasurer.
What else do you do?
I don't know.
She does it all. High and long by Israel. Praise the Lord. Praise the Lord. Praise the Lord.
Can y'all hear me okay?
Yes.
Okay, just before I start. Oh, I'm sorry. Y'all make me see
you.
Thank you.